Hello students, so now we are going to be going through the solution of the cyclic test 2 paper. This paper consisted of sums from linear inequations and trigonometric ratios. So we'll start with the solution. Question number 1. If the replacement set is the set of whole numbers, if the replacement set is the set of whole numbers means ki x can only have whole number values. X can only have whole number values, and we know whole numbers start from 0. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on and so forth. So we have 5x plus 4 is lesser than or equal to 24. This is the first question. So plus 4 goes to the right hand side. It becomes minus 4. So we get 5x is lesser than or equal to 24 minus 4. So we get 5x is lesser than or equal to 20. 5 is getting multiplied on the left hand side. When you take it to the right hand side, it gets divided. So we get x is lesser than or equal to 4. And so given x belongs to whole numbers, so whole numbers lesser than or equal to 4 would be 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we'll write the solution set properly in curly brackets only. Remember, you always need to write the solution set in curly brackets only. Alright? So that gives us the first part of the question. Now moving on to the second part. It is 4x minus 2 is lesser than 2x plus 10. So plus 2x goes on to the left hand side. It becomes minus 2x. Minus 2 comes to the right hand side. It becomes plus 2. So we have 4x minus 2x is lesser than 10 plus 2. So we have 2x is lesser than 12. X is lesser than 12 upon 2. So x is lesser than 6. So given x belongs to whole numbers, now we want whole numbers which are lesser than 6. So whole numbers less than 6 would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the whole numbers lesser than 6 will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay? So I hope you understood. Both the sums were relatively easy. That will give you 3 marks if you properly write the solution set and you show all the steps. Okay? Now, second question is from trigonometry. Prove that 1 plus cos A upon 1 minus cos A is equal to cosec A plus cot A the whole square. So we know we need to start from one side, and we have had this discussion that we will always start from the complicated side, which is the side where that contains the secondary ratios. So which side contains secondary ratios in this? Obviously it is the right hand side. So RHS is equal to cosec A plus cot A the whole square. Now, our first step is to convert secondary ratios into primary ratios. So we get cosec as 1 upon sin A, cot as cos A upon sin A. So we have 1 plus cos A the whole upon sin A the whole square. So when you expand, it becomes 1 plus cos A the whole square upon sin square A. When you open the bracket, 1 plus cos A the whole square upon sin square A. If you observe the left hand side, we don't want sin in that. We only want cos in the left hand side. Okay. So we know sin square A can be expressed in terms of cos square. We can write sin square A as 1 minus cos square A, because sin square A plus cos square A gives you 1. Sin square A is equal to 1 minus cos square A. That gives us 1 plus cos A the whole square upon 1 minus cos square A. In the denominator, we can observe 1 minus cos square A. A square minus B square. And we know A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B. So 1 plus cos A the whole square upon 1 plus cos A into 1 minus cos A. 1 plus cos A and the square gets cancelled. So that leaves only 1 plus cos A in the numerator. उससे हमारा लास्ट फाइनल आंसर आता है 1 प्लस cos a अपॉन 1 माइनस cos a व्हिच इज इक्वल टू LHS. LHS इज इक्वल टू RHS, हेंस रूफ. प्लीज मेक श्योर दैट wherever यू आर यूजिंग अ स्क्वायर रिलेशन यू हैव टू राइट इट इन reasons, जस्ट लाइक वी हैव रिटन हियर sin square a इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस cos square a एंड यू आर पुटिंग इक्वल टू sin set on every step. And in the last step, you're writing RHS is equal to LHS or LHS is equal to RHS, whichever side you've started from, and hence proved. Hence proved is very important. You need to write it compulsorily. Okay? So now moving on to the next sum, it again belongs to linear inequations. So if the replacement set is the set of real numbers, so that means in this sum, x can take real number values. Now, real number values include all the numbers, positive, negative, decimal, fractions, all the numbers which can be drawn on a number line. Real numbers mean the numbers that you can plot on a number line. So 5 minus 3x is less than 11. So we'll make the term of x positive. So minus 3x goes on to the right hand side. Excuse me. So we get 5 minus 11 is lesser than 3x. So minus 6 is lesser than 3x. 3 is getting multiplied on the right hand side. When you take it to the left hand side, it gets divided. We get minus 6 upon 3 is lesser than x. Minus 2 is lesser than x. So when you write the solution set, it is equal to x such that x is greater than minus 2. And x belongs to real numbers because this linear inequation, in this replacement set is a set of real numbers. We have to write the solution set in set builder form only. It carries one mark. And we also had to plot it on a number line. So x is greater than minus 2. So you put a hollow circle on minus 2. And you darken the entire line before that. So we've done that. Yahan pe minus 2 pe put a circle and pura line humne darken. Okay. Next. Eight plus 3x is greater than equal to 28 minus 2x. So we'll take minus 2x on the right hand side. So we get 3x plus 2x is greater than or equal to 28 minus 8. So you get 5x is greater than or equal to 20. X is greater than or equal to 4. So when you make the solution set, it comes out to be x such that x is greater than or equal to 4, comma, x belongs to real numbers. So the solution set comes out to be x such that x is greater than or equal to 4, comma, x belongs to real number. Now, when you plot it on a number line, because here it is equal to 4, so we'll make a dark circle on 4 and we'll highlight the entire number line after that, and we'll also darken this arrow. Okay. Because it is not ending, it is not stopping, we'll darken the entire line and you'll also darken the arrow. Alright? I hope you've understood the entire question one. Moving on to question two, we need to prove cos raised to 4a minus sine raised to 4a is equal to 2 cos square a minus 1. So, which side seems to be more complicated? Now, since both the sides contain primary ratios, we will start with the side which has higher powers. So we have cos raised to 4 minus sine raised to 4a on the left hand side. So cos raised to 4a we'll write as cos square a the whole square, minus sine raised to 4a we can write as sine square a the whole square. Now we have a square minus b square, and we know a square minus b square is a plus b into a minus b. So cos square a plus sine square a into cos square a minus sine square a. cos square a plus sine square a, as we know, is 1. It is an identity. So 1 into cos square a minus sine square a gives us cos square a minus sine square a. Now, since we don't want sine on the right hand side, we only want cos. So we can write sine square a as 1 minus cos square a. And then when we open the bracket, we get cos square a minus 1 minus cos square a. So cos square a minus 1 plus cos square a. That gives us 2 cos square a minus 1, which is equal to the RHS, hence proof. I hope you all have understood. This was a pretty straightforward, a pretty easy sum that you can expect for 3 marks. Just make it a point, you are writing hence proved and the square relation wherever you use it. Okay? Sure. Moving on to the next question. The next question is, sec A minus tan A upon cosec A plus cot A is equal to cosec A minus cot A upon sec A plus tan A. So since both the sides contain secondary ratios, what we are going to do is, we will start with either of them. We can start with either of them. So we'll start with LHS. So LHS is equal to sec A minus tan A upon cosec A plus cot A. Okay. What we are going to do is, we're going to multiply both the numerator and the denominator by cosec A minus cot A. The reason for that is we are trying to make the denominator equal to 1. We are trying to make the denominator equal to 1. And we know cosec A and cot A have a relation, that cosec square A minus cot square A gives you 1. Okay, so we'll use that square identity in this. So to use that, we have A plus B. We'll multiply it by A minus B, that is cosec A minus cot A. But we cannot only multiply in the denominator, we also have to multiply it in the numerator. So we'll have sec A minus tan A into cosec A minus cot A upon cosec square A minus cot square A. That gives you sec A minus tan A into cosec A minus cot A upon 1. We will leave the LHS here itself. We leave the LHS as it is. This is a little special sum, so please pay attention. Now we'll start with RHS, and the same procedure that we did in LHS, we will repeat in RHS as well. So we have sec A plus tan A in the denominator. What we are going to do is, to make the denominator equal to 1, we will multiply by sec A minus tan A in the numerator as well as the denominator. So we get cosec A minus cot A into sec A minus tan A upon sec A plus tan A into sec A minus tan A, which gives us sec square A minus cot square A. And since sec square A minus cot square A is 1, we are left with cosec A minus cot A into sec A minus tan A, which is equal to LHS. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS, hence proof. Now, if you try and convert into primary ratios and you try and solve this sum using that method, you still will be able to do it, but that will be a very long and tedious method of solving. This is the shortest and the easiest method of solving this sum. Okay, so whenever you identify, I saw cosec and cot, I saw sec and tan in the denominator, I identified unique relation. There is a square relation. So I use that. Okay. And that is the reason why I multiplied with sec A minus tan A in the right hand side and cosec A minus cot A in the left hand side, which made our solution very, very simpler and much more compact compared to if we had converted into sine and cos and then tried to solve this sum. Okay. So, yeah. That gets us to question 2C. As we had discussed in the class as well, this is the most unique type of sum that you can find in trigonometry. This has one unique solution which was taught in the classroom as well. We are just going to repeat that. So we have on the LHS tan A plus sec A minus 1 upon tan A minus sec A plus 1. which is equal to 1 plus sine a upon cos. Only for this sum, or rather this type of sum, we had discussed in the classroom that what we are going to do is we'll split the 1 in the numerator. We will split the 1 in the numerator in terms of second tan. So what we'll do is we'll write sec a plus tan a minus 1 ko we'll write as sec square a minus tan square a, the whole upon tan a minus sec a plus 1. And the reason is sec square a minus tan square a is equal to 1. Okay. Now we'll apply a square minus b square. We know sec square a minus tan square a is sec a plus tan a into sec a minus tan a. So that gives us sec a plus tan a minus sec a plus tan a into sec a minus tan a upon tan a minus sec a plus 1. Okay. So then in both these terms in the numerator, sec a plus tan a is common. So we'll take sec a plus tan a outside. That leaves us with sec a plus tan a misses sec a plus tan a common nikal gaya. So only 1 minus from the second term sec a plus tan a bahar gaya. So we are left with sec a minus tan a. 1 minus bracket sec a minus tan a. So sec a plus tan a into 1 minus sec a minus minus plus tan a whole upon 1 minus sec a plus tan a. 1 minus sec a plus tan a upon 1 minus sec a plus tan a gets cancelled. We are left with sec a plus tan a. Then converted into primary, sec a is 1 upon cos a. Tan is sin a upon cos a. Since the denominator is the same, we'll directly add the numerators. We get 1 plus sin a upon cos a, which is equal to RHS. Hence proof. Please make sure that you mark this sum, you practice this sum. This is a unique sum in trigonometry. To ensure that you have practiced it, we have included it here as well. I hope you are now thorough with the solution that you need to follow, the method that you need to follow in order to solve this sum. So moving on to the next one. Question 3a states minus 1 by 3 is lesser than x by 2 minus 4 by 3, which is given in mixed fraction form 1 by 3. So when we convert, you get it as 4 by 3, which in turn is lesser than 1 by 6. So this is a type of linear inequation where we have two inequations in one sum. We have two inequations in one sum. So what we'll do is minus 1 by 3 hai, minus 4 by 3 on the right hand side. When you take it on the left hand side, it becomes plus 4 by 3. So 4 by 3 minus 1 by 3 is lesser than x by 2. Since the denominator is same, we directly subtract the numerator. So 4 minus 1, so 3 by 3 is lesser than x by 2. So we get x by 2 is greater than 1, x is greater than 2. That is the first part. The second part is x by 2 is lesser than minus 4 by 3. X by 2 is lesser than minus 4 by 3, which is lesser than 1 by 6. So minus 4 by 3, right inside mein jaake, it becomes plus 4 by 3. Now the denominator here is 6. Over here it is 3. So we'll multiply 3 by 2 and the numerator also by 2. We have 1 plus 8 upon 6. X by 2 is lesser than 9 by 6. So X is lesser than 9 into 2 by 6. X is lesser than 18 by 6. X is lesser than 3. So when you combine the two equations, we get X such that X is greater than 2 and lesser than 3, comma X belongs to real numbers. So what we'll do is we'll make a hollow circle on 2, we'll make a hollow circle on 3, and we're going to darken the part between that. Because there is no equal to sign, we're going to make hollow circles on them, and then we're going to darken the part between them. I hope you've understood this solution as well. Just remember, the solution set carries 1 mark, and a proper number line carries 1 mark. We'll have to leave 1 centimeter gaps between every number, and just ensure that your number line is neat and tight. Okay. Next question. We need to prove cos A upon 1 minus tan A is equal to sine square A minus 1 upon sine A minus cos A. So we'll start with the more complicated side, that is the side which contains secondary ratio, which is LHS. We have LHS is equal to cos A upon 1 minus tan A. Tan A can be written as sin A upon cos A. So we have cos A upon 1 minus sin A upon cos A. Then we take the LCM, we get cos A upon cos A minus sin A upon cos A. अपॉन कॉस से ऊपर जाके मल्टीप्लाई हो जाएगा, तो वी विल गेट कॉस स्क्वायर ए अपॉन कॉस ए माइनस साइन ए. नाउ वी हैड लर्नड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इन द क्लासरूम एज वेल. ऑन द आरएचएस वी वांट साइन ए माइनस कॉस ए इन द डिनोमिनेटर. वी हैव कॉस ए माइनस साइन ए इन द डिनोमिनेटर. व्हाट वी विल डू इज वी विल रिवर्स द ऑर्डर. वी विल राइट दिस एज साइन ए माइनस कॉस ए, which in turn will change the sign. We'll write this as minus cos square A upon sin A minus cos A. If you change the order of digits, the sign gets reversed. So plus cos square A becomes minus cos square A upon sin A minus cos A. So minus 1. So since we only want sin A in the numerator on the RHS, we'll convert cos square A into sin in terms of sin A. We can write cos square A as 1 minus sin square A. We'll write that in the reason as well. So minus of 1 minus sin square A, when you open the bracket, we get minus minus plus. So we have sin square A minus 1 upon sin A minus cos A, which is exactly what we needed to prove for the RHS. That is equal to RHS, hence proof. Just one tricky step. यहाँ पे sin A minus cos A करके you have to write this as minus cos square A. That's it. Just keep that in mind. Okay? So this gives us an understanding that our entire solution has to be focused on the other side. If we are starting from LHS, we have to focus on the right hand side, like what you want there. And if we are starting from the right hand side, we need to focus on the LHS. What is wanted there. Okay. So I hope you've understood this. Last question. Find three smallest consecutive whole numbers such that the difference between 1/4 of the largest and 1/5 of the smallest is at least 3. Is at least 3. Very important. A little tricky sum. Please pay attention here. Now, since the numbers are consecutive, they've specified consecutive, we can take the numbers to be x minus 1, x and x plus 1. Let the numbers be x minus 1, x and x plus 1. So, according to the given condition, the difference means subtraction, between 1/4 of the largest. Now, amongst x minus 1, x and x plus 1, the largest is x plus 1. So, difference between 1/4 of the largest, which is 1/4 into x plus 1, and 1/5 of the smallest. So, the smallest is x minus 1. So, 1/5 is 1 upon 5 into x minus 1. Is at least 3. At least matlab kam se kam 3 hona chahiye. 3 se zyada hua to chalega, but 3 hona chahiye minimum. So that means it can be greater than 3 and it can also be equal to 3. So it is greater than equal to 3. Now once we have the equation formed, we will write this as x plus 1 upon 4 minus x minus 1 upon 5. We'll take the LCM. So 5 into x plus 1 gives us 5x plus 5 minus 4 into x is minus 4x. Minus into minus gives us plus 4 into 1 is 4 upon 4, 5 is 20. When you cross multiply, you get 5x plus 5 minus 4x plus 4 is greater than 60. 5x minus 4x is x. 5 plus 4 is 9. So x plus 9 is greater than or equal to 60. Plus 9 goes to the other side, it becomes minus 9. So we have x is greater than or equal to 60 minus 9, which is 51. So we had to find the smallest possible values of x. The smallest possible value of x is 51. So therefore, when you substitute, the numbers become 51 minus 1, which is 50, 51, and 51 plus 1, which is 52. So I hope you understood the solution for this as well. Dhyan rakhna, ek bar ye first line aage, once you are able to make the equation, solving it is not difficult. So making the inequation is a challenge. But once you have made this, I don't think solving should be an issue. So I hope you all have understood this. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you.